Alright guys, this is Zisteau. This is not another DocM intro. Maybe it's become a habit. Welcome back to the Mindcracker. We are here on the Mindcracker, and today we're going to be making the mines right over there. But first I wanted to talk about something real quick. I was thinking about my sheep storage system, and I was talking about making a whole different building, basically, to hold the sheep and to make an automated shearing system. And it occurred to me I could probably adapt what I have to do what I want. Is it starting to get dark? It is. Okay, so I have to hurry with this, and then we'll get started on the mines in the next daytime period. So this is the shape of my pens, 5 blocks by 5 blocks, most of them. And it occurred to me that the biggest problem in the pens is that you have to jump down into them to collect the wool, and then you get jostled around by the sheep, and it's hard to get always to the, you know, say there's wool over there, it's hard to get in this corner if there's sheep everywhere pushing you, and it's hard to get back out. It's just a hassle. The thing that's not a hassle is standing up above them and just shearing all of them. So I thought if I can add a drainage system, then I think I can make an automated drainage system, and all I have to do is stand at the entrance and shear them all. So this is basically how it will work. When I was making Kill the Runner, I got pretty intimate with how water flows based on the second chamber and how water has to sweep all the torches off of these surfaces. So basically, water always moves towards a hole. If you have, let's say you're putting down redstone or rail lines or something, and you don't want it to get washed away. It's dark now, damn it. If you don't want to get it washed away by water, just put a hole like this. Oh, it didn't work. Maybe because of the fence. Let's try this again. I wanted to illustrate something, but it's not exactly important. Let's see. Let's see if it works this time. It should. Those torches should be okay now. Yeah, okay, this is what I wanted to show. So if you want torches or redstone wiring or minecart tracks or whatever to be safe, dig a hole, and the water will go straight for that hole. So if you have stuff here, you can dig a hole there, etc. Right? Okay, so, yeah, see how that works? So there's a couple ways to do this. Let's see, let's put this back. I guess it doesn't work if there's something here obstructing the water from falling down the hole. You can do it like this. This is going to be getting a little dangerous. That's okay, who cares? Come get some zombie, come follow me up here. So here's one way to do it. We could do it like this. Zombie! Help! Dive bomb! Yeah, didn't get hit! Okay, the monsters are starting to pour on though. Okay, so if there's wool anywhere here, it's all gonna get pushed into that hole. Sheep can't fall down the hole though, but all the entities, all the blocks or the wool or whatever is in there is gonna get pushed down that hole and into a drainage system, which I'll build underneath everything. Let me revert this. Oops. Close this off. That's one way to do it, but there's a little bit easier way to do it, and I don't want to do it this way because there's going to be a hatch right there where my door is. So I'm going to do it like this. Like so. And this works just as good with a 5x5 room with the bigger pens that hold white, black, light gray, and gray. Those will be have to be a little bigger. But this works just fine like this. And so I'm going to have a series of pistons up here that I'll hook it all up to a redstone. So you basically just hit a button to let the water flow, run around and shear everything. And this should also, if the entrance to the little pen is here, all the sheep should get pushed right here so that they're easier to shear, so that they're not back there in the corner. And then once you've sheared everything, you can go collect everything, turn off the water, and because I think grass can't grow if there's water flowing above it. I'm not 100% on that, but I think that's how it works. Let me get out of here. There's a creeper. Oh! Okay, I'm out of here. Don't blow up my... Oh! Don't blow up my mock-up! Help! So I'm going to do that eventually. Not this video. This video I'm going to be making some mines, but that is my plan to do in the next several videos, is to automate the collection system. I guess I can't start the mines during the nighttime, so I'm going to start them out in the open. But basically, the drain would be right there with an extra fence, and then the water would be up here, and I would have a bunch of pistons set to a button. And then, so the water's going to flow this way, and then basically the holes would line up, and I would have channels dug underneath here so that everything would collect into one very convenient little spot. And I'll probably have like a little ladder with a hatch somewhere to let you go down and collect that. So anyway, that's my plans for that. I think that's going to be a good system. It'll make it a lot easier to harvest wool. And in just a minute, as soon as the daylight comes up, we're going to start the mines. So see you then. I think I mentioned this previously, but back in Mindcrack number 3, my third Mindcrack video, when I set out to look for a place to settle, I was looking for a specific set of geographical features. I had an idea for a house, and I wanted to find a certain geographical feature that would let me build it. And so this is what I was looking for. I was looking for a big vertical dramatic hill with a basically a cleft or a ravine in the middle and water in the bottom. And so we're gonna do the mine shaft first. The mine shaft's gonna be underneath the house. House is gonna be in here somewhere. I have sort of a decent, I haven't built it yet, but I have a pretty good idea of what the house is going to be like, how it's going to be organized, the shape it's going to be, that kind of thing. And so I'm going to be kind of vague about it until I actually start making it, but it's going to be in here somewhere. That's all I'll say. And the mines are going to be directly under it in this water. So let's see. These reeds are kind of in the way. Let me trim these guys a little bit. Mow the grass, so to speak. I think it was at a certain point, I think it was in Life on Bagoda when we were in Cleveland, and we had a lot of gunpowder from killing from killing creepers. We decided to make TNT, and instead of just digging straight down, we just bored a hole with TNT. And then we put water in the center, and we could basically just fall down it. So I think I'm going to use a version of that. I'm going to put a circle in the middle of this water and then dig straight down. And the water's going to cascade down the sides of the circle, so that if you want to get to the mines, you're just going to jump out of the house and basically fall down the hole and break yourself. B-R-A-K-E, not B-R-E-A-K. Break your fall with the water on the sides. So let's get up here so we can look down into it. Maybe up here would be good. I want a little bit of an overhead vantage so I can pick the spot. I want to basically center it. Fill that hole. Always filling holes. It's like a never-ending job. Let's see. So the house is going to be in between here. So I want, and the mine shaft I just described is going to be at the center of the house. So I want to center them between these two walls and between back here, I guess that back wall and this front part of the lake or whatever. Let's go way up to the top. I should probably just make a like a, not a permanent stair, but some sort of temporary way while I'm doing construction to make it easier to get up here so I can have a little vantage. I've done a little bit of sculpting. There used to be a big hole right here that I filled in. I'll probably do some more terraforming just to smooth things out. Okay, here we go. So I'm thinking something like this right in here would be a good spot. It needs to have water on all sides. If I made it here, the house would run into this. So I think it needs to be here so the house can be right in between these spots. So what I probably need to do is get down there and measure the distance and find the center block between, I guess, right there and this face, more or less. Pretty sure I can fall off this and not die. So let's say basically right there. That's what we're thinking. Yep. But I'm gonna go ahead and dig and measure, build a little platform here just to make sure, so we can be really precise about it. It's midday. We have a decent amount of time. Let's trim this too. Hey yo. Come on. Let's see. Let's make this something that we can walk up quickly. Something like this, and let's build a path across all the way. Okay. Okay, this is the face I was looking at. So let's see. It's really different looking at it from here than it is from up there. But let's measure the water. So the water starts there. 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, 15, 17, 19, 21, 20. Oh, ran out of water. Right. We'll say that's the last one. Hey, Jambé. Yeah, okay, that's close enough. So I do a lot of measuring like this when I'm building. I typically edit this kind of stuff out, but I probably leave it in this video. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 torches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that should be the center. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, yeah, that's the center. And then I want to think about how far this way, how far this way. Let's go back up top and look. And while I'm thinking about that, I have a bunch of ladders. I'm gonna need a ladder to get out of the mine. And I'm gonna need a ladder to get up top here, I think, to look at things a little easier. Maybe we'll do it right here where our scaffolding is and get up top here. Just build it right here. And this is temporary. I'll remove this eventually. Okay, that's probably a good vantage. I would like to be way up here though, so maybe I'll continue the ladder all the way up. Where did my ladder go? Is it right? Here it is. Okay, let's just temporarily do this. And stand on top of this. Break that. Ow! There we go. And then from this point, we'll just do this. Getting up here on the very top is, it's a good vantage to have to look at something. I do a lot of sort of measuring and looking at the land before I build anything, most of the time. To try and, I really like to work with the land. I'm not really interested in just making an office building or a castle or a church. that just sort of sits on a flat piece of land. If other people are interested in that, that's cool, and I like looking at other people's buildings, but I'm always interested in making something that sort of resonates with the landscape that I find, which is why I'm so particular about, you know, the features of the land where I settle. Okay, so looking up here, I think it needs to be more to the left, don't you? Don't you? This is sort of centered in the water, but it's not centered in this chasm, which I think is more important now that I look at it from up here. So let's make another center in the center between that wall and that wall. See if we can do this before darkness falls. Maybe I can get Badge to sleep in a bed. Once we start digging, I'm just gonna work through the night, because hopefully I can get deep fast enough. I've got a couple of good picks, efficiency 4. I've got another one of these, I got 2 of these, and then I have this efficiency 4, unbreaking 3, fortune 3, which I will use for diamonds and probably temporarily for coal and redstone and lapis and stuff, just till I get like a huge supply of those things, because it will last a while, that pick. Let's see, that wall is right here. So what, basically I just added another torch. So let's move this over here. And to make it stand out, let's make it a little whiter so we can look at it from up there. Oh, that's way better. Oh, see the difference? Yeah, that bigger center line mark there, I think that's the right spot to center it at. Okay, so that's where the center of it is going to be here. Now we need to think about the center in the other axis. Let's go kill this zombie. Hey, zombie! Help! Man, the lag has been not bad. I mean, I didn't get hit at all, and I was rushing right up to him. That's a good sign for the Mindcrack server. Okay, circle's finished. Let's take a look. This is a circle with a 13 block diameter. This is the size I was thinking of using, but after looking at it, I think it's too big. Yeah, I think that's better. Okay, let's do this one. So let's start digging this. Hey-o. So to do that, I brought this gravel. Actually, let me check something real quick. Yeah, I think that should be okay. Whoa! Whoops! Just want to drop some gravel at the corners to mark where it go, where it do what it do. Let's see, that was one. Then let's drop another one here. And with a circle this small, it's more like, it's actually an octagon more than an actual circle. It only has 8 sides. So I can just do the corners like this and then connect up the corners with straight lines or diagonals. Okay, I don't want to be right there. I'm going to fall again if I do that. There's the 8 spots filled in there. So now I'm just going to fill in the circle. Hey-o. Okay, let's take a look. Yeah, it looks nice. It looks like a good size. Looks like it's located in a nice spot. I might even move it this way one block to give it a little more clearance on, you see this side here? I may move it that way one block. But it looks nice. It looks like a big, it's going to look like a huge hole in the water. But it's not going to be so big that it doesn't swallow up, you know, so that there's no water left. I like it, but I'm thinking, now that I look at it from up here, I'm thinking of moving it that way one block. And it looks a little weird because it's got this thickened edge, but it's still the normal octagon that it was before, but I did move it over. There's a better gap between here now, which I like. I think we're ready to go. So first thing I'm gonna do, I guess I'll dig down this shaft all the way down, and then I'll dig a ladder back up, and then we'll start doing the whole thing. Here we go, bedrock. All right, that didn't take too long. Okay, and then let's clear out just a little room here, put some boxes in the wall. And then we'll dig a ladder straight up. Should be, I think, this direction. Straight over there. Man, all that digging makes me hungry. Okay, let's see, boxes. I think it's this way. It should be, yeah, direction zero is south. I'm pretty sure my house faces south. I'm pretty sure this is the direction I want to go. So let's dig back here, maybe like 12 blocks, maybe 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 9, 10, 11, something like that. Okay, light everything up. And then head back for the surface. See, that'll be a fun thing to jump down. I love jumping off stuff in Minecraft. It's one of my favorite things to do, so I want to incorporate jumping off things into my house. Hopefully there's no lava pools or anything down here. Oh, there's some water. Oh, it looks like I measured totally wrong. All right, get out of here. Oh yeah, I didn't go far enough. That's no good. Okay, I'm gonna have to move that. Let's see, where is it? Where is the hole? I suppose I could leave it like that. It would keep monsters from falling down. Okay, so maybe I will leave it like that just to keep monsters from falling down the hole. I was gonna put a hatch at the top, but since it happened like that, that's fine. We can work with that. It's not that big a deal. It's kind of funny. Okay, so next step. The next step is to start clearing this thing down all the way. So that's cleared out. This is the shape I'm gonna dig all the way down. Eventually I'll dig out these blocks here and let the water cascade down. Let's see. Okay, I have a pretty good amount of space. Oh look, I got a free sword. That was nice of them. All right, big money. Efficiency 3. Yes. All right, found my first section of diamond. Let's see how many we get. Yes. Oh, yes. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is like, what is that? Five or six? How many we get? Give me the diamonds. 13. That is awesome. 13 diamonds from that. Great. That is really good. Oh, I'm so glad I have this pick now. And after about a zillion iron picks, we finally got to the bottom and hollowed out the whole thing. And I want to show you something in just a second. Hopefully I can hurry up and do this quick enough. Come on. There's a limited window of opportunity here, literally. Gotta hurry up. Now check this out. Pow! The hole is exactly the same size and shape as the moon. Well, actually, I guess the moon's a little bit bigger, but isn't that cool? That's one of those things, happy accidents. Although, after I build my house, you won't be able to see that. But still, that is pretty cool. You can see the passage of the moon. It's too bad that the way daylight works, it's just global lighting. So it's not like you have to wait till noon for light to hit the bottom here. It doesn't work like that, but that would be cool if it did work like that. Let me go ahead and torch up the bottom here. And the moon's gone. So there we go. The mine shaft has been dug, or at least the basics of it. Next time we'll be setting up the patented pinwheel parallel mine down here, and then after that we'll do something to this and add the water. We'll make this surface look cool, put some recessed lighting or something like that. So see you next time, guys. Hope you enjoyed the video. See you later. Take it easy. Have a good day. Bonus reel! I thought I'd show what it looks like from above with a little bonus clip. Check that out. Whoa! Creeper! Let me repair this real quick. Wow, that almost could have been my death if he had been just a little bit closer. Get some torches back. I'm not sure where he went. I thought I had checked my angles. Maybe he came from down here. But it's kind of hard to get out of there. Anyway, whoops. Let's see what it looks like. So eventually you'll be able to jump off of here into there from here. That'll be pretty fun. I love jumping off stuff in Minecraft from elevations. There's our mine shaft, the start of it. Kind of looks like the Sarlacc pit. See you next time, guys.